It's time you gave him everything. Don't worry about tomorrow. He said he'll give you more than enough. Trust Jesus, he will never fail. Walk with him, walk with him. Love beyond forced rhythms of grace. Yeah, yeah. Grace is shining out. You have nothing to prove. Grace is shining out. He'll fill the gaps, take the slack. Grace is shining out. It's time you gave him everything. Don't worry about tomorrow. He said he'll give you more than enough. Trust Jesus, he will never fail. Walk with him, walk with him. Learn the unforced rhythms of grace.
Good morning, family. Greetings in the wonderful and precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. I trust that you're well and blessed. We are so excited that we are now open. All our branches are open for in-person service. We will continue on the online platform, but it's so wonderful that we come together and fellowship and just love on Jesus. We want to encourage you. If you're not aware of that, please note that we are open and we would love to see you in our in-person services at any one of our campuses. Now, you know, I'm so excited, family. On a Sunday morning, one of our leaders, Devin, shared on the offering message. And at the end of the message, he released a prophetic word where he declared that this week is going to be a supernatural week. And I want to assure you one thing, the past week has been such an amazing week. God has really been supernatural. He's opened up some significant doors and that word has worked. I am so convinced that we are living in a new day. We are living in a new norm, not a new norm naturally. A new norm spiritually. You must understand that whenever God does something new, it's always on a higher level. It's always on a greater dimension because he wants to display his goodness. And that's what this new norm is about God displaying his goodness. And we can function in that new norm if we can change our thinking and change our believing and trust God for greatness. So I'm excited this morning. Can you close your eyes and bow your hearts as we pray and come around God's word? Let us pray. God, we love you with all our hearts. We thank you that you're the God, the same God yesterday, today, and forever. You are God of signs, wonders, and miracles. And I pray that even as I would speak, Father, as those would listen on different devices, Lord, I declare that your anointing will flow into their hearts, into their lives, touch them, Father, challenge them. And Lord, I declare that signs, wonders, and miracles will follow the preached word of God in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Now this morning, family, I'm speaking on building your cup for a double portion. And I believe that that's what God has for us. God's heart and God's desire is for us to excel in every area. And so building your cup for a double portion. Now let's lay a foundation first and then we'll go into our teaching for this morning. We're speaking from Psalm 92, verse 10 declares there, "But my horn, my emblem of strength and power, you have exalted like that of a wild ox. I am anointed with fresh oil for your service." And so the series is entitled, "A Fresh Anointing to Rebuild." And God declares here that you are anointed with fresh oil. You are anointed. And this anointing is so powerful that the Bible says that it has the power and the strength of that of a wild ox. And so, family, it shows us then that this anointing has the ability to help us overcome every area, every challenge, and every circumstance in Jesus' name. Now, when you look at the purpose for this anointing, it goes on to say, for your service. And there's a twofold purpose here. Number one, God wants to serve you the purposes of God. When God gave us the blueprint of the Word of God, in the Bible, are over 6,000 promises for you and for me. Promises for different seasons, promises for different circumstances, promises for different situations. You have to know that God's heart as a father, because he loves you so much, is that he wants to administer and he wants to allow the promises of God to manifest through your life. And so firstly, God wants to serve you the purposes of God. God wants to serve you the promises of God. God wants to release greatness in your life. But secondly, family, what we find then is that not only for us, but more than that, God wants now that which is in us, the blessing that he bestowed in us, that we can serve others in Jesus' name. And so we see it's a twofold blessing. Not only are we going to be blessed, not only are God, is God going to serve us, but God in turn will use us to serve others in Jesus' name. Now, we're looking at the concept of building a cup. The Bible says in Psalm 23, verse 5, "Thou anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows." We looked at a scripture in Corinthians where Paul teaches the cup of blessing. And so for the last few weeks, we've been looking at building a spiritual structure within us that can house the anointing, that can house the fresh oil that God has poured out in the season. If we don't build a cup, then what we must understand then is that the anointing, we will not be able to contain it. And when we face a circumstance, a challenge, a difficulty, we then, family, will not be in a position to overcome, because we won't have no oil. And we know the story of the 10 virgins, amen, that they ran out of oil. And so when you understand the significance of the oil, those that ran out of oil, when the bridegroom came, they could not connect. And so it becomes important for us to build that structure. And so this is our fourth session on building the structure. And it's because it's so wonderful. Last week we spoke about building your cup. Build my cup, Lord. But this week we're dealing with building a cup for a double portion. Now, when you look at the concept of a double portion, interesting, Elisha knew the God that he served. And so when Elijah was being taken away, Elisha declared, "I want a double portion of your anointing." Family, you can, as you build your structure, your spiritual structure within your spirit and your mind and your heart, you can receive a double portion. And I want to encourage you, you must build for a double portion. Our anchor verse is found in Revelations chapter 18, reading verse 6. It says, "Render to her just as she renders to you, and repay her double according to her works. In the cup which she has mixed, mix double for her." And so we see that there is a cup that we can develop, that we can grow, that we can put structure around, that can cause us to receive a double portion in Jesus' name. And so when you look at some prophetic scriptures in the Bible, because we begin to look at the heart of God and understand the heart of God, the Bible teaches in Deuteronomy 1 verse 11, it declares there, "May the Lord God of your fathers make you 1,000 times more numerous than you are, and bless you as he has promised." And so we see, family, that God's heart is to make you 1,000 times more than you are. You go to Amos chapter 9 verses 13, it declares, "Yes, indeed, it won't be long now, God's decree. Things are going to happen so fast, your head will swim, one thing fast on the heels of the other. You won't be able to keep up. Everything will be happening at once, and everywhere you look, blessings." This is an amazing decree. God says, "I'm going to do so much for you that your head will swim," meaning this, that you will be so overwhelmed by what God is going to release. We are living in this season and we are living in this day where God wants to do so much for his sons and for his daughters. The Bible declares in Psalm 118, verse 25, "Save now, I pray, O Lord, I pray, send now prosperity." God wants to release the prosperity to you in Jesus' name. And then the Bible declares in Joel 2, verse 23, "Be glad then, you children of Zion, and rejoice in the Lord your God, for he has given you the former rain faithfully. He will cause the rain to come down for you, the former rain and the latter rain in the first month. We are living, family, in a new day and a new season, and this speaks of an overlap of sowing and reaping, the former rain and the latter rain. There's an overlap of seasons and an overlap where God wants to bless you significantly. And in Ephesians 3:20, now unto him who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all we ask or think, according to the power that worketh within us. Remember, if we don't build this cup, we won't have the anointing, we won't have the oil truly, and in the oil is the power of God. And so we have to build a structure so that which God has for us, we can manifest. And so this morning, I want us to look at a prophetic picture in the Bible. And as we study it this morning, we begin to see four key principles that will help us build our cup. And family, if we can understand these principles and apply them effectively, we will get the outcomes that God has for us in Jesus' name. And so we are dealing with preparing your cup for a double portion. Go with me in your Bibles to Isaiah 54. We're going to read from verses 1 through to verses 4. It declares there, "Sing, O barren, you who have not borne. Break forth into singing and cry aloud, you who have not labored with child. For more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married woman, says the Lord. Enlarge the place of your tent and let them stretch out the curtains of your dwellings. Do not spare, lengthen your cords, strengthen your stakes, for you shall expand to the right and to the left, and your descendants will inherit the nations and make the desolate cities inhabited. Do not fear, for you will not be ashamed, neither be disgraced, for you will not be put to shame, for you will forget the shame of your youth and will not remember the reproach of your widowhood anymore." And so here, family, there are four key principles that I want to bring to your attention. And as you apply these principles, you could get to a place where you could build a structure within your spirit, within your heart, where you can receive a double portion in Jesus' name. And so the first verse, verse 1, declares, "Sing, O barren, you have not borne. Break forth into singing and cry aloud, for you who have not labored with child. For more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married woman, says the Lord." And so here we see a prophetic picture here. And the first principle I want you to see, family, is this, is the principle of seeing. If you cannot see what God has for you, you will never be able to walk in the fullness of that which He's prepared for you. And so here the Bible says there, "For more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married woman." And so God wants you to walk in the fullness of that which He has for you in Jesus' name. And so you're going to have to see it. You're going to have to see it, because when you begin to see what God has, then you can begin to build your faith capacity to receive that which He has and that which He has prepared for you in Jesus' name. Look at the Bible declares in Romans 8 verses 18. It declares there, "I am convinced that the suffering we endure is less than nothing compared to the magnitude of the glory that is about to be unveiled within us." Family, if you are only focused on the challenges and the circumstances and all that you're going through, you will never see the magnitude of the glory that's about to be released within you. I can assure you, David declares, you are anointed with fresh oil. You do have oil that God has released in this new season. But if you are so focused on the challenges and the circumstances, you will never see the magnitude of the glory that God wants to release in you. The word seeing, when you study it in the Hebrew, it's the word discern. And so, family, you're going to have to discern. You're going to have to recognize. You have to find out, get an understanding of what God has for you. And you can only do that through seeing. The Bible teaches that where there is no vision, people are destroyed. People perish. And so you're going to have to see it through the eyes of faith in Jesus' name. The Bible teaches in Matthew chapter 9, verses 2. It says, "Then behold, they brought him a paralytic lying on a bed. When Jesus saw their faith," Jesus can see those sons and daughters that operates in faith, and he can see those sons and daughters that operate in fear, that operate in a world system, that operate outside the faith of God's word. And so if you can have knowledge of the word, but if you don't believe by faith, there will never be a demonstration of that which God has for you. Your faith is either active or inactive, family. And so we have to get to a place where we activate our faith so we can get the outcomes that God has. The Bible teaches in Hebrews 11:27, it says, by faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible. Moses, who was so sold out, Moses was so connected to God, Moses was so in tune with the Spirit of God that he could see him who was invisible. I declare that you see the breakthrough. You see how God's going to restore. You see how God is going to bless you. You see the tremendous things that God is going to do, how he's going to heal you in your mind, in your body, in your spirit, in every sphere of your life, and show himself strong on your behalf in Jesus' name. The second principle is found in verse 2. It declares there, enlarge the place of your tent and let them stretch out the curtains of your dwellings. Do not spare. Lengthen your cords and strengthen your stakes. And so the second principle is the principle of doing. The word doing means to accomplish. It means to bear fruit. It also means to bring forth. And so, family, God's heart and God's desire is that we must be doers of the word. You have to activate this word. You have to start the journey of your life plan, your destiny, that which God wants to do. You have to activate and you have to start. If you don't do what God has called you to do, you will never walk in the fullness of that which he has in Jesus' name. 2 Chronicles 20:32, the Bible declares, and he walked in the way of his father Asa and did not turn aside from it, doing what was right in the sight of the Lord. And so this is Jehoshaphat. And so Jehoshaphat understood that if I want God to use me, then I have to do what is right in the sight of the Lord. You know, family, God is omniscient, meaning that God is all-knowing. God sees everything. Everything that you do, God sees. And the things that you don't do, God sees it. And God blesses you according to that which you do. And when you walk on the water, when you believe God, when you trust God, God will show himself strong on your behalf. Hebrews 10:36 declares, for you have need of endurance, so that after you have done the will of God, you will receive the promises. And so if we want to receive the promises, we have to do the work of God. And so let's look at an example. Let's deal with debt cancellation. There are things that you can do, family, in order to activate this grace, activate this anointing, and allow God to expand you. And so number one, you can look at all your accounts and you could print them out and compile all your debt. You can then, secondly, go to the Word of God and get three scriptures, three promises that deal with debt cancellation. For example, the Bible says, owe no man nothing except to love. And so you can have these scriptures. And then number three, you then can set aside time, whether it's the morning, afternoon, or evening, where you can pray over those scriptures and pray it in. The Bible says we must call those things that be not as though they were. And then number four, you could sow a seed and trust God that you can receive a harvest of debt cancellation. So you can do something, family. And if you do your part and if you do your side, God will do his side. God will bless you. The Bible says, if you draw nigh unto me, I will draw nigh unto you. And so if we do our part and our side of it, God will come through and show himself strong on our behalf. The third principle that we find is found in verse 3. It declares there, for you shall expand to the right and to the left, and your descendants will inherit the nations and make the desolate cities inhabited. The third principle is expectation. Expectation is the breeding ground for the miraculous. Most people that don't have vision, most people that don't have a dream will never have expectations. This is the challenge. If you don't have a dream or a vision, your opportunities will present itself from time to time and season to season, but you will never see it if you don't have a vision for your life. And so those that have vision, those that have dreams, those that have a plan for their life, God will begin to place a spirit of expectancy within you, where you will trust God and believe God and expect God to show himself strong. And then when the opportunities get presented, you will see them and you will know that that is of God. Look at the Bible declares in Psalm 28 verses 7, it says, Yahweh is my strength and my wraparound shield. When I fully trust in him, help is on the way. And so family, you have to fully trust God. You have to have an expectation that because I fully trust you, help is on the way. Listen to me. You have to respect the process. The Bible declares in Psalm 23, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Note, it's not the valley of death, it's the valley of the shadow. A shadow is not real. A shadow has no solid content to it. A shadow is just a reflection. The devil will put a reflection of death, a shadow of death, a shadow of destruction, a shadow of hurt, a shadow of confusion, a shadow of disappointment over you. But know this, that when you walk through that valley, it's a valley of a shadow. It's not real. God will deliver you. God will show himself strong. God will manifest his goodness in your life, because it's not a real solid valley. It's a valley of a shadow. It's only a shadow, meaning it's only a season. And as you walk through it, you will overcome. Why? Because you have an expectation from God that he will deliver you and he will show himself strong on your behalf. And then lastly, the last principle in verses 4, the Bible declares, do not fear, for you will not be ashamed, neither be disgraced, for you will not be put to shame, for you will forget the shame of your youth and will not remember the reproach of the widowhood anymore. Family, this speaks of sons and daughters who are fearless. The Bible declares in Daniel 11:32, they that know their God shall be strong and shall do great and mighty exploits. You know your God, and no matter how difficult or how challenging or how trying the season is, God declares that because you know him, you are strong and you will do great and mighty exploits. And so let me close with this example. When you study the life of the disciples, very interesting that they were not fearless when they first started walking with Jesus. But over a period of time, we begin to see that they grew in faith, they grew in confidence, they grew in the word, they grew in revelation, they grew in understanding, they grew in their anointing. You might have been through some trying and difficult and challenging seasons, but I want you to know those seasons and those experiences has developed you. Those experiences have grown you. Those experiences have built you up in your most holy faith. When you look at Luke chapter 5, and I won't read the scripture because of time, but Luke chapter 5 from verses 4 onwards, the Bible speaks of the disciples that were out fishing. The Bible says they fished the whole night and they caught nothing. And then Jesus comes and says, cast your net to the other side. And they do that. And the Bible says they catch such a significant haul of fish that their nets began to break. And family, it speaks of challenge, the nets breaking. It speaks of disappointment. It speaks of failure. Because imagine you catch such a big haul, and in that haul is the potential to allow you to be debt free. And then the net breaks and you lose all the fish or most of them. And so we begin to see here that the disciples, you know, this was in the early days of Jesus' ministry, just as he started his public ministry. But if you go down to John 21, this is 3.5 years later, towards the end of Jesus' ministry, The Bible says there that they were fishing and Jesus again appears and they catch such a significant haul of fish. The Bible declares there, but the net did not break. Why? Because you see, family, when you're fearless, you're not defined by your failures. You're not defined by your past. You're not defined by your mistakes. You are defined by the Word of God. And because you're defined by the Word of God and the promises of God, God is not a God of a second chance. He's a God of another chance. And so this morning, I want you to know that as you pour your cup for a double portion, God wants to show himself strong. God wants to administer to you his grace, administer to you his anointing, and bless you significantly. And so this morning, allow me to pray for you. Father, I declare that we are building our cup. Father, that our cup, Lord, according to your word, we will walk in a double portion, double for our trouble. I speak that over your people's lives. I speak that into their lives. And Father, I declare in this new season and in this new day, we are expecting you to show yourself strong on our behalf. And now, Father, come on, blessings upon your people in the name of the Father and the Son and the precious Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise God forevermore.